a murderous schedule at 6-2. Take on the upstart Louisville Cardinals, who are 6-1. Hi, everybody. Dan Shulman and some kind of pumped up Dick Vitale. Now, I know Rick Pitino tried to tell you, hey, Dick, this is just another basketball game. What do you say to that?
Well, Dan, you know, the bottom line is Kentucky-Louisville, one of the three great rivalries in basketball. Duke, Carolina, certainly Indiana, Purdue. What makes this special? You got great players, but also the mystique. Rick Pitino on the sideline with Louisville. And then the soap opera gets bigger. Marvin Stone, who was the star here in 2002 when he wore the uniform. Yes, wore the uniform of Kentucky. Now he's wearing the Louisville uniform. And what, it's going to be an unbelievable scene. I can't wait. I'm so pumped up. I got goosebumps. Kentucky, Louisville, Marvin Stone wearing a Louisville uniform. I mean, I can't even keep up with it. It's so wacky.
We'll see if Dick can pace himself through 40 minutes. We got Jimmy Dykes here just in case we need three guys on this kind of a game. Jimmy's going to tell us about Marvin Stone, the new and improved Marvin Stone, wearing the Louisville uniform. Jimmy?
Hey, guys, I tell you what, it's been a great partnership so far between Marvin Stone and Rick Pitino. Marvin Stone needed more discipline. He needed more playing time. He's receiving those opportunities. And Rick Pitino needed someone in his lineup taller than 6'7". Interesting that Rick Pitino would gamble on Marvin Stone when he just has one semester of eligibility left, adds even more fuel to the fire in this rivalry. And Marvin Stone told me yesterday, this is just another game. There's no way you can be standing on this floor where I'm standing right now and not know that something special is getting ready to happen in this building.
I'll tell you one thing, Jimmy. 2 years ago, Marvin Stone had 11 points, 6 rebounds, and he sparked Kentucky to the win over Louisville. Now, can he do it in a Louisville uniform? The only player ever to wear both uniforms.
Kentucky holding a 23-10 advantage all time. They didn't play for almost 60 years in the regular season, but this is the 20th year in a row that they have met. And there's a whole lot of red in here, just a little bit of blue sprinkled around the building as Eric Daniels gives the visiting Wildcats an early lead.
Eric Daniels has been a big plus after being suspended earlier this year. Came in against North Carolina, was a spark in that win over North Carolina.
Key matchup, Reese Gaines now back at the point for Louisville. He's moved over from the off guard. They're All-American candidate. Freshman Francisco Garcia from the Bronx. No fear at all.
They really like him. If you talk to Rick Pitino, he says his upside is incredible with quickness, athletic ability. He did a great job utilizing the screen to shoot that three.
Let's set the starting lineups for you. Of course, Marvin Stone, the big man in the middle for Louisville, allowing rebounding machine Ellis Myles to move to power forward. And Kentucky, they are getting healthier and healthier. Both coaches, Dick, really searching for a rotation, but in a good way. These are a couple of very deep teams right now.
Well, you know, Kentucky was playing without Cliff Hawkins, who's now eligible academically, and also without Antoine Barber, who will see minutes here today. Former junior college superstar, but out with a broken hand.
Offensive foul against Kentucky. Gerald Fitch picks up the foul. Rick Pitino's second year at Louisville, took him to the NIT last year with 19 wins, but they didn't lose much from last year's team. Stone comes in. Garcia, a very highly thought of freshman. Tyquan Dean, another freshman that Pitino says has a chance to be one of the great shooters in the history of the Louisville program.
Well, you know, Dean's averaging 14 points a game in his last four games.
There's a look in the corner for Eric Brown. It's off, and Kentucky on the run. What about the pace of this game here today, Dick?
Well, you talk about the pace. Obviously, one of the keys is going to be the fact of whether Kentucky handles the pressure of Louisville. Full court traps, and on the other side, can they handle Estill inside, who has been a strong second-half player? Tubby Smith. I mean, they ought to give this guy so much love for the job he has done down there at Kentucky. They better give him some love, man. There's some NBA jobs opening up, and I know some people that really like him in the NBA. He's an outstanding coach,
a teacher,
motivator. Just leave him alone. Those fans have such a passion, but sometimes they get carried away.
Every year his name comes up whenever there's an NBA opening. This is his sixth season at Kentucky. Bogan's off with his first long-range jumper. He is shooting the ball exceedingly well, and there's Garcia, who already hit the three, forcing a turnover.
A lot of intensity on that floor. I think really important, Dan, very essential for Louisville to come out and take charge early in the game to have these 19,000-plus fans going bananas. Just look at Garcia out of New York City, played a lot of AAU basketball, which certainly helped his development.
Look at the quick release. He came in, he's 6'7". He came in at 162 pounds, up to 180 now. And here's Bogans at a rock solid 215, slamming it home at the other end.
Well, you know, Bo Myles, to me, has had probably the best year in terms of improving, turning around a disastrous sophomore and junior year, because he's attacking the basket better, and it's allowing him to get better looks from the three, and he's shooting the three-point shot better than 40%.
I think it was Tom Izzo who said after the Michigan State game that Bogans is the poster child for guys who should stay in school for 4 years.
Well, you know, Keith Bogans was trying to impress NBA scouts. We're going to take a look here at the ball popping loose. That's an easy douche for the former DeMathis superstar. Play for Morgan Wooten, who's retired, one of the greatest coaches ever to grace the sideline.
I got to tell you, folks, this is about the 15th game I've done with Dick this year. He is most excited today that I've seen him all year. You are pumped for this, huh?
I always get excited for hoops, but today I'm so excited. It's incredible. I mean, it's unbelievable. We should get paid for sitting here. I mean, this is just so special.
Little touch foul there on Stone. Yeah, you're going all right. You're going to be able to make it for 40 minutes?
Patino told me before the game, says, you're not playing, Dick. Calm down.
Well, this I mean, you talked about some of the great rivals. You mentioned Carolina, Duke, Indiana, Purdue. Those are in-conference rivalries. This is by far the best out-of-conference rivalry in America.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. In terms of, you made a good point about the others being within a conference play.
That foul, by the way, on Stone, his first, and Louisville can ill afford getting him into foul trouble. Third turnover already committed by Kentucky. Louisville on the run, but they can't get a shot off. Great effort, though, by Gaines to save it. And look at Garcia. Made his first, missed his second, airballed his third. He said that ball was deflected, but the officials don't agree.
He's hurrying on that shot. He's really not patient enough right now to diaper dandy. He's got to be a little bit more patient. I think this Kentucky team, people, by the end of the year in March, they're going to be dynamite. Yeah. I really believe that.
There's a push from behind. Myles is going to get the call.
I think when you look at this Kentucky basketball team, when they get into the rhythm with guys like Barber and Hawkins, as you look here at the series history, Kentucky leads 23-10. Last meeting was a blowout. It was a situation where he just didn't have enough personnel to compete down there at Kentucky.
It's a much deeper team now for Louisville. It was last year at this time, just before this game, where Marvin Stone effectively left the Kentucky program, transferred, had to miss the first semester of this year, but eligible for the bulk of the season, which is why Louisville has backloaded their schedule. Their difficult games, even out of conference games, none of them really were in the first semester. Very few of them were in the first semester.
There he is, showing his inside, outside ability. Hey, don't think he just became a player. This kid came out of Alabama, was highly recruited, so much so, he was subject of a chapter in the book Soul Influence by Dale. There's a jumper by Bogans by Dan Wetzel and by Don Yeager. They did a chapter on Romancing the Stolen.
Right.
Excellent book by those two guys, Wetzel and Yeager.
Marquis Estel with a putback at the other end. The biggest difference, if you talk to the Louisville staff, is Stone's stamina, his body. He's much stronger, he's much leaner, and he's become a much better player because he's in better shape.
Yeah, he's in better condition, better attitude, too. Mentally, he's happy, he's content. Didn't get enough playing time in his eyes. We're going to see Mr. Stone now show his versatility, show he can shoot the J, baby. It's rocking here at Freedom Hall.
The 2003 NCAA Women's Basketball Championship on ESPN and ESPN2.
They call it the season of hope, the season of joy, the season of light. When parents seem more like children, and children more like angels. And on behalf of your good neighbors at State Farm, we want to wish you and yours all the hope, joy, and light the season has to bring.
Oh, the things we do to stay young looking. How is it we forget the best part of our face, our smile? This is a new toothpaste from Crest. It's called Rejuvenating Effects. It gives you three ways to help keep your smile looking and feeling younger, longer. One, it strengthens enamel to fight cavities. Two, it whitens teeth. Three, it refreshes gums with a tingly sensation. Rejuvenating Effects? I'll take it.
With rugged all-wheel drive and better handling than ever, the new Subaru Outback gets you closer to nature without getting in the way of nature. When you get it, you get it.
See your local Subaru dealer for information on financing as low as 0.9% APR. exclusive presentation of NCAA basketball is brought to you by the beauty of Subaru all-wheel drive. When you get it, you get it.
1 point lead early for visiting Kentucky here at Freedom Hall in Louisville. Dan Shulman, Dick Vitale, and Jimmy Dykes with you. And here's Jimmy on one of the things the Louisville folks were really worried about before the game, Jimmy, and that's rebounding.
Well, I talked to Louisville coaches this week. I watched them in practice yesterday. They're concerned about Kentucky's ability to do that right there, an offensive rebound and a putback, which is why they shoot about 50% from the floor as a team. It's very interesting that Louisville comes in, guys, averaging plus 10 rebounds a game, Kentucky only plus 2. The team that's plus 10 is concerned, can they rebound with a team that's plus 2? Here's all you need to know about Kentucky rebounding. They out-rebounded Michigan State, Dick. That says it all right there.
Well, you know, statistics can be certainly deceiving when you look at the rebound total. It's an 8-1 margin right now. A lot of those stats were achieved against subpar competition. So obviously that's a different story than what Kentucky has faced. They have faced a dynamite schedule. The schedule out of conference gets tougher for Louisville later on with Indiana and Tennessee and people like that.
Zone look here from Louisville, and that shot was blocked. Daniels on the glass, and there's another second opportunity for the Wildcats.
Yeah, beating them on the offensive glass. And I'll tell you another area Rick's got to be a little concerned. They're shooting too quickly and hurrying up on the offensive end rather than having some patience.
Well, you would imagine if one of these two teams is maybe a little too pumped up for this game, it would be Louisville. They're younger. They're at home. They've got Marvin Stone and Rick Pitino. This Kentucky team is a very experienced group.
Well, Kentucky did a great job right there in transition after the turnover. They did a phenomenal job of doubling up in the post as Rick gets a timeout. They doubled up on Stone, and the turnover led to a layup. We're going to watch it right here. See, look at the double up right here. Excellent job by Bogans. He deflects the ball. Now Estill's going to get it out, release it, and then they are in transition. Nice pass by Finch. Great dump off. There's the conversion by Daniels. Excellent transition basketball. Look at that fire in that. I tell you, this guy can flat out motivate and coach. Think about the 3 years in 96 to 98. I mean, it was amazing what they achieved. In those three-year period of time, they won over 100 basketball games. Won the national title in 96, 97 went to the final game, and 98, Tubby Smith takes over, and they win the national title.
A down year for Kentucky is losing 10 games and getting to the Sweet 16. Of course, under Denny Crum, Louisville had a lot of success with a couple of national championships, fell on some relatively lean times in the mid-90s. But Rick Pitino is known as a guy, Dick, who comes in to a program that's struggling, and within a couple of years, he really turns them around.
Well, to me, he's born to be a college coach. His enthusiasm, his energy. You know, and I mentioned those 3 years. They set a record for most wins over a three-year period, 104-11 from 96 to 98. Now, that's domination. Yep. That's incredible.
7 points, by the way, already for Eric Daniels, who's making just his third career start here this afternoon.
And the game they lost for the national title, Arizona, they played that last part of the season without Derek Anderson, one of their stars.
Luke Whitehead into the game now, and he draws a foul on Daniels. So Whitehead, who's replacing Myles in the last couple of minutes, will head to the line. You talked about guys who can flat out motivate and coach. Bobby Knight and Texas Tech heading back to Big Ten country to take on the Gophers immediately following our game here today on ESPN. And then his old school, Indiana, will take on Temple at 4 Eastern. Still waiting for word on whether or not there will be any disciplinary action against Mike Davis.
Well, I was with Carl Ravage on SportsCenter, and as I said then, we've got to give the guys some love. I mean, I talked to writers with Bosich, Vicky Weiss. They were all here. They said immediately after that game, Mike Davis was contrite. He apologized. He was sorry. He said he humiliated his team, his university, and he did. You can't condone what he did, but a 6-game suspension would be ludicrous when you think about Joe Paterno running on the field in football in that Iowa game, and certainly he didn't get a suspension. Hey, Mike Davis, at most, maybe 2 games, but I'd give him a little love at the holiday season and give him one.
He will coach today. They may find out Monday whether or not he's going to be suspended. Louisville has stepped up the defensive intensity on this trip down the floor. Tough baseline jumper for Fitch.
I'll tell you, Fitch was so big in that Carolina game. Played boys, had 25 points. Carolina loses last night. Oh. They might have lost more than the game. Could be a season losing Sean May for 8 to 10 weeks. We wish Sean nothing but the best coming back from that broken foot last night and a loss to Iona.
And he was the only true big guy that Matt Doherty was giving minutes to. Now,
exactly.
Now Jawan Williams and Melvin Scott also didn't play in that game, but without Sean May, boy, all of a sudden Carolina looks very thin up front. There's Stone working hard inside to miss, and Eskel, and these two guys are good buddies, trying to body up on one another today. Bogan's out of control, but it's going to go against the Cards.
Now, a little bit out of control, but that's his strength, attacking the basket. On the other end, the game plan by Kentucky is excellent defensively. As you're going to watch him spinning in the lane, trying to get a one-on-one, which he excels at. But what a great job defensively on the post. See, look at all the help Estel's going to get in here. See the help? Look at the help by Hayes. I mean, they're making life difficult for Marvin to get any kind of angles to drive to the basket.
You know, Estel and Stone, as mentioned, good buddies, and they practiced against each other while they were teammates for 3 years, so they know each other's moves as well as anybody on the planet.
They were great friends. They were really close. They still are very tight. They are very familiar with one another. One of the real problems with Marvin Stone at Kentucky was very simply playing time. Was very unhappy. Didn't get the kind of playing time that he thought he should get coming out of Alabama. But he didn't show consistency as a player. Was inconsistent as you look at Tubby working that sideline. I tell you, a lot of NBA teams are going to be interested in Mr. Smith. I can tell you that. And there's an opening down in Atlanta. All you fans, man, build a monument for what he's done there in his 6 years. He's a great coach, not a good coach, a great coach.
Bogan's out, and Cliff Hawkins checks into the game for the first time. Came off the bench in his first game last week against Indiana. 26 minutes, 5 assists, 5 rebounds, and he might move back into the starting lineup at some point. But what an option off the bench he is right now for Tubby Smith.
He didn't shoot well in that game, which you expected. He's 1-for-6, but he did a great job penetrating.
Nice two-man game between Garcia and Stone.
Excellent play. Stone to Garcia, showing that athletic ability. Excellent two-man. Gets a good angle. Here comes the trap. They've been spreading the court really well against the trap.
Taekwon Dean into the game now, the sharpshooter for Louisville, just a freshman. There's Jules Kamara getting his first action of the day. He's lost some minutes. Kind of fallen on hard times the last few games, but he's got a pretty nice jump shot from 8 feet right there.
That'll get you some minutes right there. The one thing about Tubby Smith and Rick Pitino, if you compete and you play well, you're going to play. It's what you're doing now. It isn't about your memories and your scrapbook.
Here's Dean. His first three, a little bit long. And another rebound for Kentucky. Louisville get beaten down the floor right now. Fish gets an open look. Offensive rebound again and a block. Garcia got Hayes, but Daniels got the rebound.
I'll tell you, Hayes and Daniels are just warriors. They really climbed the glass. I know Kentucky fans have to be excited with this early start and the performance of Eric Daniels.
Gaines in some heavy traffic right now. Now an open look. No second chances for the Cardinals. Kentucky with numbers. Louisville looks a little tired right now. They're getting back down on defense.
Louisville not doing a good job defensively in transition, and a poor job in executing in a transition game by Kentucky. They're not rotating back. They're trying to rely on that three-point shot with dribble penetration and kick the ball out. We're going to watch right here. There's the block right there by Garcia. I tell you, Garcia, a good-looking young player. Rick Pitino's on the money telling me that kid's going to be a star.
Very assertive very early in this game. Antoine Barber into the game now for Kentucky. We've got two very deep teams. Dean takes a bump, no call. Stone on the baseline draws the foul.
Marvin Stone cannot get a good look. They are really doing a phenomenal job defending Stone and really are attacking him, not allowing him to get a good look and cutting off angles. What a story he was coming out of. Like I said earlier, he was the chapter devoted to him, romancing the Stone, coming in out of high school. He's had some tough luck in his life. Lost his dad and his sister very early in his life. And, you know, that's got to be psychologically such a blow to a young guy. And you root for kids. You want to see kids do well. And you hope and pray that he takes advantage of the opportunity now here at Louisville. 14-1 on a glass. I mean, they're dominating him on a glass.
Stone's third game with Louisville, had double-doubles in each of the first two games as Bogans, and again, Louisville gets beaten down the floor on defense.
That's Bogans at his best. getting in transition at 40. And Nick Bosich wrote about him today, two outstanding writers here from Louisville, and talked about his driving game. And I'm going to tell you something. You saw an example of it right there in transition.
Bogan's averaging 19 points per game as a senior. He's got five already here today. Now Louisville turns it over. Bogan's got his hand in there again. Nice drop pass to Esther.
This is not the start that Louisville and Rick Pitino were hoping for. They certainly wanted to come out and set the tempo, get the crowd into the game.
Kentucky turns it over, but they've still got an 11-point lead at one point way back when. Tubby Smith, Rick Pitino, part of the same staff. We'll take a look back in time after this.
Early in the morning when I wake up, I think, have I dreamt this whole thing? I get up and realize that JetBlue is serving tens of thousands of people on a daily basis.
East with three or four elite teams right now. Same can be said for the SEC. Kentucky is one of them. Why are they beating Louisville so bad?
Well, take a look at a great blockout right here on a free throw line. Execution right here with a blockout by us. Now watch that blockout. That initiates the transition game. Gets the great blockout. Gets the ball out quickly. Now we're going to watch right here and try to freeze it. Look at this transition. Look how slow they're getting back, these five. They're beating them down the court for layups. Beating them down the court. Rick Pitino cannot be happy with their defense in transition.
One thing you always think about with a Rick Pitino coach team is they're going to be in better shape than you are. They're going to tire you out. He's going to use more guys. You never see, or you rarely see, a Rick Pitino team get beat in transition as many times as has already happened here today.
Well, you know, Dan, I don't think it's so much fatigue that's making it happen. I just think a lack of execution, rotating back. Just thinking about transition. They're struggling offensively against the solid defensive team of Kentucky. If you had to define Tubby Smith, I would say Tubby Ball can be defined very simply. Great defense and rebound in his tenure at Kentucky. Teams defend well, they rebound well, and when you do that, you got a chance to win.
Ryan Norton out of the game for Louisville. Crowd wanted an offensive foul there on Cliff Hawkins using that left forearm. Here's Estill backing down Stone, finds the open man. The 3 won't go down for Barber.
Antoine Barber, great shooter. Give the bounce back. Should have given it up. 2-on-1. He's got to drop the bounce pass for the layup. Clinic 101. Stay a little wider than the lane. Make one guy have to play two. Take a look right here. Not right here. Freeze it. Right here. He's got to draw him to him, and he's got to get the angle from here and drop the bounce pass. Not good execution right there.
Got lucky, really, that Hawkins was called for a touch foul, his second foul of the game. Garcia's had some very good moments early. Well, Louisville didn't even get a shot attempt there on the 2-on-1. And they're looking for Stone inside, but again, Estill playing some good deep. So it's Myles, not known for his offense, has it stripped. And back come the Cats again, 4-on-3.
Myles a good offensive rebounder, but he better start rebounding because they're not on the glass at all here in this basketball game. It's 15-2 on the glass.
Morgan finally gets one for Louisville.
They got to give Dean some looks.
There it is. Offensive rebound, no. Another one. And a foul. Finally, the Cardinals getting some second opportunities. For more on the rebounding, back to Jimmy Dykes.
Today in practice, Rick Pitino time and time again kept saying, box off. We can't turn this into a jumping contest against Kentucky. They're too strong on the boards. I'm sitting underneath the Kentucky basket. Not one time so far in this ball game have I seen a white jersey go attack a blue jersey when the ball's above the rim. You know that's being talked about in that huddle.
Well, you got to block out, Jimmy. That's the key, no doubt about it. As you look at the numbers here, now up to 15-5. It was 15-1 at one time. Now it's a 3-1 ratio.
Well, and you made the point, Dick, that Kentucky already this year has played Michigan State and Indiana and Virginia and Gonzaga and Arizona State. I mean, they've had maybe the toughest schedule in the country. So when you look at their numbers, they're a better team than their numbers would suggest. If you look at Louisville's numbers, their toughest games, really, they lost to Purdue. They won at Seton Hall, but they've also played Furman and Manhattan. And no disrespect, but the talent level isn't the same on that level. Louisville's got more to prove here today, I think, than Kentucky does.
Well, Rick Pitino reminded me that Manhattan last night beat St. John's to set up a consolation. St. John's in North Carolina in the Holiday Festival. Manhattan and Iona in the final.
Another second opportunity. Pitch throws up the prayer. Estill's on the glass. Look out. As it's out of bounds to Louisville. Tonight at 8 Eastern here on ESPN, Capital One Bowl Week continues with a classic clash as number 14 Colorado and Chris Brown take on Anthony Davis and Wisconsin in the Alamo Bowl presented by MasterCard. This one is a battle of the running backs between Brown and Davis. That's tonight at 8 Eastern right here on ESPN after a triple header of college basketball action here this afternoon. Stone looking for his offense.
Interference, no doubt about it. Louisville making a little bit of a run here. Now getting back down to seven. They got to be patient. Lots of time. Rick happy with that effort. Going to watch the ball up on the cylinder. Internationally, you can play with that ball up there, but not here. Hey, you mentioned, you know, shooting the three has been horrendous. Louisville's 1-for-8, and Kentucky has taken the Schneid 0-for-7. My math tells me that's 1-for-15, man.
And both teams came into the game shooting the three extremely well. When you and I saw Kentucky against Carolina, Kentucky shot 10 of 16 from three-point range. But on the other side, when they lost to Virginia, they were just 2-for-22.
Right. That three-point shot certainly changes the complexion of the game. Here's the pressure. They've done a good job against it. The traps, spread the court. See the excellent spacing. They're so well drilled. Both these clubs really understand all the nuances that make up the game. Yeah.
And again, they are experienced by today's standards in big-time college basketball. This is a very experienced group. But Esto just picked up the foul for giving him that shoulder. We are midway through the first half here at sold-out Raucous Freedom Hall in Louisville, the annual game between the Kentucky Wildcats and the Louisville Cardinals, along with Dick Vitale and Jimmy Dykes. I'm Dan Shulman. The early story in this game has been rebounding. The Wildcats much more physical early than the Cardinals.
I'll tell you, Louisville needs a three. Get this crowd going. Just keep them back in this game.
Esther, by the way, that was his second foul. Got to be careful as he got in the air there. Came back, and despite the two fouls, picked up the block shot. I think Tubby's about to get him out of the game as well, the next opportunity.
What a great pass. What a look by Bogans.
Antoine Barber on the receiving end.
Antoine Barber was one of the impact junior college players coming into the collegiate game, according to many. Ricky Clemens doing a job as a junior college player down there at Missouri. And the kid we saw the other night, Yoreda. Doing a heck of a job for LSU. Sparked LSU in that game against Arizona. Going to watch the dump here. Look at the block. Excellent angle. Excellent angle. Esto with the good block. Look at that bounce pass. Great 45-degree angle. Good look. Bogans spread the court. Garcia doesn't see ball, you man. They finish.
If there is a concern for Kentucky right now, it's a bit of foul trouble. Esto has gone to the bench with two. Fitch just picked up his second. He remains on the floor, but maybe not for long, as Brandon Stockton's about to check in for him.
I think Keith Bogans has done a heck of a job attacking the basket and also with his great passing ability here as well. Solid player.
This is a guy Louisville's got to get going. Their Wooden Award candidate, Reese Gaines, who averaged 21 points per game last year, says he might not score as much this year because he's got Marvin Stone to help him out on the inside.
Well,
foul on Gaines. He doesn't like that at all.
He didn't have a good game against Kentucky in their last game. In fact, three games he's averaged 14 points a game, but had only one really good game against Kentucky. They concentrate on him and really put a lot of pressure, averaging 19.6. Bogans averaging 19. He has 1,508 points in his career. Mr. Gaines.
And Dick, that was the second foul on Reese Gaines, and that could be a major problem for Louisville. He's indispensable for them. Here's Stockton off the screen, launches that awkward-looking shot of his, and he missed it. Kentucky now 0-for-8 from three-point range.
Yeah, it's amazing. Up 7, shooting really poorly, but so it's good. Both teams, you know, do an excellent job defending the three. They really attack the three-point shooter. Fantastic. Didn't have a good angle. That's not the angle you're looking for.
We'll step aside. Kentucky leading by 7. Rick Pitino's got to be concerned about the rebounding and the pinpoint passing for the Cats.
Oh, there's Bogans with the great drop down. That's Mr. Barber to Chuko Super.
With rugged all-wheel drive and better handling than ever, the new Subaru Outback gets you closer to nature without getting in the way of nature. When you get it, you get it.
See your local Subaru dealer for information on financing as low as 0.9% APR.
The conference season is back.
Look at the dish! And look at the square!
With the return of Big Monday as Big East powers Notre Dame and Pittsburgh square off, followed by Big 12 favorite Kansas against Iowa State. Then, Super Tuesday debuts, Oklahoma taking on Connecticut, and SEC heavyweight Florida against up-and-coming Mississippi State. Big Monday, presented by Bud Light, January 6th. Super Tuesday, presented by Dollar Rent-A-Car, January 7th, on ESPN and ESPN.
Hey, Wildcat and Cardinal fans, looking for a store that offers the best of both worlds? Then come to J.D. Becker, the UK and UofL Superstore. At J.D. Becker, you'll find the largest selection of both UK and UofL products anywhere. And J.D. Becker has exclusive designs you won't find anywhere else. You can even shop our store online 24 hours a day at jdbeckerstores.com. So if you're a Cardinal fan or a Wildcat fan, come into one of J.D. Becker's UK and UofL Superstores, conveniently located inside Oxmoor Center and on the Outer Loop in the Outer Loop Plaza.
December, the time for holiday, family and friends, and a new Chevrolet. Hi, I'm Mike Coyle at the Coyle Chevrolet Superstore in Clarksville. Let us make it easy for you to buy your next new Venture van starting at $369 a month. Trailblazers with 0% financing for up to 60 months, and Silverados starting at $265 a month. We look forward to seeing you during the holidays here at the Coyle Chevrolet Superstore, conveniently located behind the River Falls Mall in Clarksville. Look for the big American flag because we'll be there.
Reese Davis with you in the studio. Tennessee State and Ohio State Buckeyes with a 6-point lead already. Sean Connolly is going to clean things up and put it in for the Buckeyes. Tennessee State playing in this game without its head coach Nolan Richardson III, suspended by the university. The NCAA is investigating that program, guys.
Well, Ohio State, the next opponent, Reese, for Louisville. Again, Rick Pitino's kind of backloaded his schedule for when Stone became eligible and let his freshmen Garcia and Dean get a little more experience. They've also got a game on ESPN against Tennessee late January. They got Indiana coming up in February as well. So although their schedule, at least compared to Kentucky's, has been a little bit easier so far, it's going to get tougher later on.
Well, you know, Conference USA certainly is going to have a lot of formidable opponents as well. But whenever you're building the program back from where it was, the bottom line is you're trying to get some confidence and get some wins in there as well to let these kids really start to believe.
That's the other thing about Conference USA. It's 2 7-team divisions this year. Won't be next year. But Louisville is on the same side as Cincinnati and Marquette. So they play both of those programs twice this year. And Cincinnati and Marquette are both playing some pretty good basketball early in the season.
What a great job they did, though, spreading the floor and spacing right there to attack the traps on the perimeter.
Knocked away by Stone. Kamara runs it down with the shot clock now under 10. Turnover, Kentucky.
You know, you mentioned Cincinnati's won 7 consecutive years. They have won the Conference USA. And we saw them with that unbelievable game against Oregon. Then they came back and they lost to Clemson, who's one of 11 unbeaten teams right now. Some of them are going to get tested, though. You got games coming up where Alabama's going at Utah's undefeated Alabama.
Myles inside, misses the layup. Oh, what a feed from Garcia, who's out in midcourt. Can't believe that that one didn't get finished.
You know, Garcia's just a flat-out player. He can pass the ball. He can shoot the ball. He's active. He'll create problems on a defensive end. He's got a star all over him in the future. You got to convert on that. You got to score inside. Miles got to convert right here. Watch this dump down. Look at the great look. You got to convert this layup. I mean, I can make that layup. Give me the rock. I can make it. Hey, Jimmy, you got to make that layup.
If you're going to win this ball game, you have to, Dick. You know, interesting, Louisville right now, they're using some Princeton tendencies in their half-court offense. To run a Princeton half-court offense, you have to have a five-man that can pass the ball. Miles and Stone can do it awfully well, but they got to finish around that rim, Dick.
Yeah, they got to finish on the inside. You look at Kentucky right here. I'm going to tell you something. By the end of March, I really believe that this club, if I had to pick four teams that I'm thinking Final Four, I'm thinking Kentucky. When they get all their parts and all their pieces, this club has chemistry. Last year, they did not have chemistry.
Yep.
They didn't have togetherness. And it was a soap opera. It was as the world of the Cats turned.
Nickname players, team turmoil, right?
Oh, man. Players transferring. Players upset.
Lots of suspensions as well. Now, Eric Dana's got a late start this year because of some summer league play. There's Stone on the inside. But now, with Daniels back, and there are 9 guys. Tubby Smith can send 9 guys out there in his regular rotation. There's a timeout as Louisville starting to step up the trapping and the pressure.
That was a good trap right there, but he had no vision to find the opening. You got to spread the court against the trap. We're going to watch him right now spreading the floor. We're going to see the inbounds. Louisville always putting pressure, tenacity, always attacking. Now here comes the trap. Freeze it. Freeze it right here. See, here comes the double up on the ball, but look at the spread. 15 feet apart, you reverse the ball, and you got the ball up the court. Excellent job by Kentucky. Well coached against the pressure.
Don't forget, after us, the next game of the triple header finds Bob Knight and the Texas Tech Red Raiders back up in the Big Ten country to take on Minnesota. That's at 2 Eastern. And then game 3 and 4 Eastern, number 11 Indiana, led by Tom Coverdale and their outstanding freshman, Bracey Wright, taking on the Temple Owls later today, all part of the big triple header right here on ESPN.
And it's great to learn that John Chaney will be on the sideline. You know, I mentioned earlier, there's 11 unbeaten teams. Some of them are going to be really challenged. You got Creighton with an upcoming date at Xavier, Pittsburgh at Georgia, St. Joe's got a future date coming up within the next few days at Gonzaga. Alabama's at Utah Monday night. That's not going to be easy for the Crimson Tide. I'll tell you that. With Majerus up there, that's going to be tough.
And if Pittsburgh gets by Georgia, you and I will get a chance to see Pittsburgh take on Notre Dame a week from Monday, which should be a great Big East game.
Should be outstanding. Yeah. Look at this here. Breakdown defensively.
Barber misses an easy one after a beautiful feed from Daniels. Louisville on the run. Whitehead back into the game. Ball off the fingertips of Garcia, out of bounds.
That pass by Whitehead, who's a slasher, threw the ball at the kid's feet. Must have made that catch.
Garcia certainly has not looked in awe of this situation at all. Just a freshman. Take another look at the pass.
Right down on his feet. I mean, that's just not going to get it done. See, patience right now. Patience and poise, so important against pressure. Look at the way they finish. Bogans again. America, remember the name. Mr. Bogans has become the player that he was as a diaper dandy, because his sophomore and junior year, it wasn't Bogans playing for Kentucky.
Numbers really went down last year after he contemplated going to the NBA after his sophomore season, but playing the best all-round basketball that he's played at Kentucky right now.
And he's enjoying college. Forget about the NBA. There's plenty of time. I mean, he's really got to think about his future. He'd become a basketball vagabond had he left early. He'd be bouncing from one league after another.
Off the glass, no good. Well, Louisville has missed countless 3- and 4-footers so far. Bogans, quick trigger. Not there. A little push off for Louisville. Goes uncalled. Cardinals on the run. Dean pulls up from 15.
And he can shoot the ball. Out of Neptune High School, Neptune, New Jersey. Had a great coach down there named Larry Hennessy. And that's also the school. Hey, high school that produced a famous actor, Jack Nicholson.
Hey.
Yes, sir. Jack, a big basketball fan. Went to Neptune High.
Crowd back into it now. Freedom Hall. Kamara the miss. And a foul underneath going against Louisville. Let's go back, talk a little bit more about Keith Bogans as we send it back to Jimmy Dykes.
Hey guys, the whole key for Louisville's pressure, Dick, full court, is to turn the guy with the ball, turn his back. But Bogans is too big. He's 6'5 and a load, and right now Louisville's having a difficult time getting him to turn so they can run at him. He's breaking that pressure off the bounce. He's got great vision as a passer.
And he also knows how to create angles. His experience, 4-year player, has played in a lot of competition. Big time competition wearing that Kentucky uniform. They play the best, man. They want to play the best.
That last foul, by the way, went against Stone. His second, Marvin Stone, is out of the game right now. Louisville going with a much smaller lineup. Kendall D'Artes at 6'10 has checked in for Stone, but he's not nearly the physical presence that Stone can be with his size.
Well, you know, came in with a big time reputation out of junior college, out of Vincennes Junior College, out of Indiana.
Tough gainer for Bogans.
Bob McAdoo played there. Mickey Green years ago went to Michigan. Started at the University of Michigan.
Eric Brown on the drive for Louisville, and he's fouled on the floor before the shot. Louisville's got to feel pretty lucky to be down only 7 in this game.
Exactly, because the bottom line is it looks like they've been dominated by Kentucky, and they're just hanging and hanging. And if they knocked out some of the threes, which Mr. Pitino's famous for, remember when he went to Kentucky, Pitino's bum, I mean, they were shooting the three like you could not believe. Also, when he was at Providence in 87, goes to the Final Four with a guy by the name of Billy Donovan shooting the three for Providence.
Another part of a later Kentucky staff.
Oh, what a
under
staff.
Rick Pitino.
I think it's one of the greatest staffs ever assembled.
Here comes Dick, just for you,
look
right there.
Look at this staff. Are you kidding me? Sendick, Oliver, Willard, Pitino, Tubby, and Billy Donovan. Another staff that can really match that was the staff that Pete Smith had when he had Roy Williams, and he had Bill Guthridge and Eddie Fogler, and they had a heck of a staff there in Carolina.
Cardinals back within five. Stockton into the game at the point. Now turnover. Louisville's got it, but we've got a whistle and a foul. Only the players can hear the whistle in this building right now.
It is unbelievable here. You cannot believe it. How big is this game? Let me tell you how big this game is. Yesterday, we go to dinner at Morton's. We're all sitting having dinner, having a great time. All of a sudden, I'm approached by these people for autographs, pictures, and they said, you got to come into this room, and you got to give a toast, because we're having a wedding, and what we've done with the wedding, we have changed the wedding from 2 o'clock to 5:30 for the game. And that was Beth Shore and Rich Banks, and we wish them the best. I know they're all watching. Mr. Banks and Ms. Shaw, we wish you nothing but health, happiness, success, and we love being with you at your big party last night.
Louisville fans?
I'll tell you this, majority of them, I asked, I did a poll.
Yeah.
All for Kentucky, let me hear you.
Really?
It was Kentucky,
wow.
Like 90%.
Wow.
Yeah, I couldn't believe it.
Eric Brown is Northern, the former walk-on, now on scholarship. Launches a three, and it's a two-point game.
Gotta get you some extra scholarships. You're not first down. I mean, are you serious that they're only down two? Kentucky's gonna lace them up, man. They're in for a war here this afternoon.
Daniels, the lob, come out of the finish.
Nice play, breaking the pressure. The one thing about the pressure, you're gonna be susceptible to some layups. But it does speed up the tempo of the game. And the one thing is, Rick Pitino likes to have the game at a fast pace.
Nobody's shooting the three very well.
Wow.
Kentucky hasn't hit one. You know, Dick, Eric Daniels gets absolutely no publicity. He's got 9 points, 6 rebounds, and 2 assists in the first half.
And he played so well since coming back. He's been a factor. Since Michigan State, he was a factor. And they lost that heartbreaker when Bograkis hits his only three.
Yeah.
The sixth option of Tom Izzo with 49 seconds to go. Hits a three as they were down by two. Michigan State to take the lead.
Rick Pitino's kids are back in the game. The life is back in the building. It looked like Louisville might get run out of the gym here early, but for the last 6 or 7 minutes, they've kind of been even on the boards. They've started hitting some shots, gotten to the line, and amazingly, Louisville's back within 4 points here, 2.5 to go in the first half.
Well, you know, we talked about earlier, unbeaten teams. Bottom line is, it's so difficult today with the parity. You and I had the game the other last week, LSU.
Yeah.
That crowd was rocking. The home court is so special in college basketball.
Well, Rick Pitino said that very message to the fans today up on the scoreboard before the game, a tape message. He said, they're good, we're good, they're excited, we're excited. He goes, here's the difference.
And
West Virginia beat Florida. LSU beat Arizona. Why? Home court advantage, the sixth man. And he implored the crowd, make it as tough on Kentucky as you possibly can.
Yeah, he really did. Gave a nice little message, but he said, you know, be good sports as well.
Yes. And there was an earlier message from the PA announcer. I guess somebody threw something on the court. You hope that doesn't happen anymore at all.
Nice ball movement.
And it pays off. A three for Bogan.
See, now he's shooting the three within the offense. He's not forcing like he was doing at so many kids. He was trying to prove his sophomore and junior year for the NBA people that he had range, and he was hurting his stock. His stock went up this year because he's playing the game like Keith Bogans can play. Attack the basket, take the three when it's available.
First made three-pointer of the afternoon for Kentucky. The lead back up to 7. Northern, another long three. His second in a row.
He had been a big plus off the bench with those two threes. The last minute so big for Louisville to make sure they hang to go in that locker room, believing they can win.
Oh, Northern took an elbow in the face, and then he gets called for the foul.
Northern cannot believe it. Tony Green talking to him, saying, calm down now. He said, look, he hit me in the lip. He hit me in the lip. He's making like Sugar Ray Leonard, man. He got me in the lip.
Well, Hawkins didn't like how tough the D was from Northern. Northern was right up in his face.
Look at Northern. He's playing all you man. I mean, playing him as tough as can be. Pressure on the ball. Hawkins came out of Oak Hill Academy. Played with Steve Blake, Ron Slay. Pretty good high school team.
Northern, by the way, 2 threes today, matching his output for the first 7 games of the season. As he has really given them a spark off the bench. Here's what Hawkins did against Indiana in his first game back from the academic ineligibility. Crowd fired up at the officials right
now. Oh, that's the elbow. You got to call that. He got a lucky break there. Kentucky got a lucky break. What a turnaround. What a turnaround. But there's the three, man. This is the big three by the form of walk-on. He's going to earn some PT. Nothing but nylon.
Now that is Mad Dog defense. Now it's a good tactic. If they just work it a little bit more like that.
Impossible.
Here we go.
Nice tip. Way to crash the board.
Basketball 101. Basketball 101.
We need to hurry up. What are they taking their time for?
Talk to somebody. Talk to somebody now.
Bush League, that's all it is. Nothing but Bush League.
Always collapse.
Come on, push it, Fisher.
Come on.
Run.
Knock him down.
That's the limit. Don't foul.
It's a disgrace. Just a disgrace. They ought to be ashamed of themselves.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Paul Pierce, all-star forward.
Jerry Rice, 12 Pro Bowls.
Eric Winalda, 3 World Cups.
When you're the best, you play the best.
The infusion from Spalding.
What's the infusion? It's a pump inside the ball.
It's always ready to play.
No needles, no pumps.
No problems.
Forget these.
Perfect balance.
No flat ball.
No flat game.
Just twist.
Pump.
Lock.
Can play. The new line of infusion game balls from Spalding.
Play the best.
Play Spalding.
Theft Auto, Vice City, in stores now. Rated M for mature.
Reese Davis back with you, checking on Central Connecticut State and UConn. 10-point game for the Huskies. Tony Robinson's really provided Calhoun's team with an offensive spark this year. Drains to three. It's a 20-point lead at the break.
Connecticut legit in one of the 11 unbeaten teams remaining in Division I basketball. Both Louisville and Kentucky have already lost so far. Cardinals are right back in this game. Brian Northern's given them a real spark with two threes off the bench, but then picked up a foul when his lip got in the way of Cliff Hawkins' elbow.
I mean, it's 31-30-27 at that time. Now watch right there. There's no question he got hooked right there. Should have been a whistle right there. Northern can't believe it. Almost going down and he says, hey, come on, you got to blow the whistle there. You got to blow the whistle. They blew the whistle, but blew it against Northern.
Northern, as a walk-on the last 2 years, played in every single game the Cardinals played in. Taekwon Dean.
Taekwon Dean's got great range. That's his big asset, his ability to shoot the three. He's averaged 14 a game the last four games.
Recruited sight unseen by Rick Pitino out of New Jersey. Dean wanted to come play for Pitino. Pitino said, you know, usually I got to win you over a little bit. Dean said, you got me.
Yeah, he wanted to play for Rick, didn't even visit. Same with Garcia. They fell in love with Mr. Pitino. Pretty good resume he's got as a coach.
D'Artes in the game. Boy, Bogan's really getting physical now with Dean. Doesn't want to give him any space. Eric Brown into traffic. It stays with Louisville.
Taekwon Dean has that unique ability to step out, get that great rotation. When he shoots it, you feel it has a chance to go in. He's got that rainbow three.
Well, it's Dean's shooting. Look at this. Look at this. Dean's shooting at the two, really one of the big reasons why Gaines has moved back to the point for the most part.
Well, they're trying to get Gaines also to be at the point to take advantage of his size. He creates a lot of matchup problems, has improved his ball handling skills. I think Rick Pitino has to be ecstatic to be able to go in the locker room, whether he's down 5, 6, or 3, because the way the first 14 minutes, they were getting dominated on the glass. It looked like Kentucky could have their way. Instead, we are going to have one unbelievable second half battle.
Barber inside. Loose ball. And Louisville's got it as time runs out on the first half.
Very fortunate for Rick Pitino to be down only 33-30 to have a chance going to that locker room to win in his big rivalry. And don't believe this is just another game. These people here take it really seriously. Down in Kentucky, Rick Pitino said, the difference is it's life and death.
Yep.
He said, they'll go outside in the cold and stay out there for 40 minutes out of games and are only minus three. I mean, he's averaging 19 points a game. If Lugan's going to win this basketball game, Gaines has to be productive. On the other side, Estill's only got 2 points on the interior for Kentucky. I think they got to go inside to him in the second half like they did against Indiana, like they did against North Carolina. As you look at the stats, 1-for-11 from the three-point line has absolutely kept Louisville in the game, because had Kentucky made those threes the way they were playing earlier, they would have blown this opening. Last 5 minutes.
Marvin Stone, who got so much hype coming into the game, 6 points and 3 rebounds in the first half. There's the rebounding story in the first 10 minutes. And after that, had Louisville not gotten on the glass, this game might be over by now, because they were getting crushed early, and Kentucky's lead got up to 11. Let's go to Jimmy Dykes.
Guys, I talked to Louisville staff as they came out of the locker room, and as all great coaches know, they kept it simple at halftime. Calm down on offense. We can't take bad shots. That's what triggers the Kentucky transition game. And then they say we spent a lot of time on rebounding. No surprises, but they kept it simple. I like that approach.
Now they went inside trying to get Stone involved in the first possession and committed their 8th turnover of the game.
I think they got to win the first 4 minutes here in the second half to get some momentum and to get that crowd really electric.
Still nice speed inside. Daniels, no, had to switch to his weak hand, the right hand, to try to lay it in.
Estill, good passer, but I'd like to see him try to finish on the inside. And attack Stone inside.
By the way, the Louisville bench was instrumental in getting them back into the game in the first half. Brian Northern and Tyquan Dean. There's Garcia beginning the second half the way he began the first half.
But he didn't force that three. And Louisville is going to utilize that three. It has been a big lift. Northern knocks down two. And the one by Tyquan Dean gave him a great lift at the end of the half.
Daniels leaves that 15-footer short. Body's on the floor.
I'll tell you what, do they want it? Yeah. Do they want it? Look at the skin. Look at the hustle step. We're talking bowl season football. These guys are playing like football. Hey, by the way, football, Kentucky should hire our buddy who we met last week at lunch with Dale Brown. They should hire Doug Williams. He'd be a great hire from Grambling State.
Take a look at the football intensity that we're seeing here on the basketball court today as the Cardinals have come back and tied it up with Kentucky.
ESPN Full Court on pay-per-view. To order, call your cable company, DirecTV, or Dish Network.
My son, Brian, and I are making sure everyone in Chicago is eating good.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. How you doing?
Hey, thanks.
You need some nice hot chunky soup to fill you up right.
Introducing Campbell's Chunky Herb Roasted Chicken with potatoes and garlic. Big chunks of savory roasted chicken and loads of veggies.
Are you a good player?
He's a great player. Do you want to see?
Duck.
Goop.
New Campbell's Chunky Roasted Favorites fill you up right.
With its new available Power Stroke diesel and 5-speed automatic torque shift transmission that generates 560 pound-feet of torque and 325 horsepower, the Ford F-Series Super Duty pulls faster and easier than any other diesel pickup. Ford F-Series, the best-selling truck on the planet.
Well, guess that settles that.
Yep.
It's built Ford tough.
Do you have good credit?
Mm-hmm.
Or do you only think you have?
Hmm.
Do you know how to check your credit report and find out? A surprise on your credit report could mean you'd be turned down for a mortgage.
Yeah.
A car loan. Even a credit card. Which is why you should log on to freecreditreport.com. Freecreditreport.com will show you how to find out online what's in your credit report, who's been checking it, and whether everything's accurate. So log on to freecreditreport.com today. You're going to do it now, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Great. Now, how about you?
Back at Freedom Hall, the Louisville Cardinals have come all the way back from an 11-point deficit to tie it up with Kentucky. If you believe in omens, as we bring the football theme back into it, in the last 8 years since the football series was renewed, whoever won the football game lost the basketball game. Kentucky won the football game this year. So does that mean that Louisville is due to win here today? There's the omen. Now, how about the trends about trying to beat Rick Pitino twice in a row?
Well, you know, when you think about it, Kansas, for example, gave a real beating in 1989. They blew him out 105. I mean, it's unbelievable, the beating in his first season. Really ripped, whipped them big time, humiliated them. Then he came back, it was 150 to 95 in his first year. The next year, he whips the Jayhawks by 17. I think about the year against the University of Massachusetts. He loses, Tamby's phenomenal in an opening game, and then they come back and they beat him in the NCAA Final Four. So this guy has been very tough to beat the second time around. He has a way of really motivating. I would have loved to have been in his locker room before the game. I was teasing him. I said, hey, you're telling me this is just another game? Well, let us put a microphone in your locker room and hear you address your team.
Esther, by the way, with a terrific block on Stone. James still looking for his first field goal of the day. And again, Kentucky tries to beat him down the floor. Esther to Fitch, but Fitch misses the runner. And Louisville, whose last lead was 5-4, they've got a chance to take the lead.
Give it inside. Get inside the Stone. He was right open there. Too late getting the ball.
Forces it up. Won't go. Rebound Esther.
Half a second late getting him the basketball where he had the angle for the drive.
Louisville strips Esther. They get another chance. Myles getting bumped by Bogut. Got a size advantage on him. And he draws the foul on the floor against Bogut.
Look at Stone right here. He wants the ball inside. Very active. Has trimmed his body. Got the ball a little bit too late. Should have had the ball a little sooner. Would have had a better angle for the drive.
Since he came to Louisville, cut his body fat from 15% down to 8%. Lost about 20 pounds. Remember, he's just got the rest of this season in terms of college eligibility.
Russell, you better lose some weight if you're going to play for Mr. Pitino. He made one of his assistants lose weight. Scott Babbable was over 75 pounds. Rick Pitino runs a minimum of 5 to 6 miles every day.
And over the holidays, he kept the kids on the floor, right? The day before Christmas, Christmas, the day after Christmas.
Oh, session. Yep. All he wants for Christmas is a big W over Kentucky. Beautiful wife Joanne in the house today with his children as you see him practicing during the Christmas break.
There's his quote, basketball is Santa Claus. All they want for Christmas is basketball. Sold out crowd here, about 19,000. Louisville second in the country in attendance last year. Who was first? Kentucky.
Well, you know, they love their basketball, both these schools.
How about Hayes? Hayes and Daniels, the unsung stars again here today for Kentucky.
Well, they're warriors. I talked about it earlier. They attack the glass. They play on the defensive end. Very physical. Daniels very active as a player. Those are the kind of kids that you need in your lineup to win.
Round for three.
See, the three-point shot is coming up big now for Louisville. That three, as we said, changes the complexion. Again, that's a steal off the top.
And Louisville has a three-point lead.
Make no bones about it. No matter what happens here this afternoon, Rick Pitino and Louisville basketball is back. There's the steal. There's the reverse. The kickoff to the open man. Great look, Garcia with the conversion. Rick Pitino ball is back in Louisville. And it's going to get better and better with the recruits they're bringing in.
Yeah, they're getting deeper and more talented every year. Hayes wide open in the corner. Gets it back, but over the back go the Wildcats.
But see, that's a shot that don't allow Hayes to take. That's not the strength of his game. Even though he was wide open, that is not his strength. His strength is physical play around the basket. You know, you mentioned the recruits coming in. They got a kid coming in, Daniels, a heck of a player, Nate Daniels, about 6'8". A kid named Brandon Chetkins from out of Detroit. And they're hoping to get a commitment out of Jamie Lang. He verbalized he was coming. But then his daddy would think about Kentucky as well. As his mom said, he's still open.
Marvin Stone working hard on the inside, but had it swatted away. You look again at some of the numbers. Reese Gaines, All-American candidate, 2 points today, no made field goals. Louisville getting out-rebounded, and they're winning. Three-point shooting has been a big difference in this game. Kentucky just cannot hit from outside. Louisville 6-15, Kentucky's 1-12. Garcia with a miss.
You can see a little spark in the Louisville kids defensively. A little bit more energy.
Myles averaging better than 9 rebounds per game. And overall, the team rebounds are just about dead even right now. And remember, at one point, it was 15-1 for Kentucky. All Louisville here in the last couple of minutes. More effort, more intensity, more rebounds. And Louisville down by as many as 11 in the first half. They've got a 5-point lead on the Cats.
Diane Lane has been nominated for a Golden Globe in the role of her career. Richard Gere, Diane Lane.
Do you love me?
Of course I love you.
In an Adrian Lyne film, Unfaithful. Own the DVD or rent the video today.
Ford Focus performs as great as it looks. It's got a European-tuned suspension for exceptional maneuverability and handling. That's why Automobile Magazine calls it the best small car to drive. If not the cleanest, Ford Focus.
Let's do it.
Okay,
look, once you get the ball,
where did they go? And that is Mad Dog defense. Oh, it's a good tactic. If they just work it a little bit more like that.
Impossible.
Here we go.
Nice tip. Way to crash the board.
Basketball 101.
We need to hurry up. What are they taking their time for?
Tackle somebody now.
Bush League, that's all it is. Nothing but Bush League.
Always come at
it. Come on, push it, Fisher.
Come on.
Run.
Knock him down.
That's an old limit. Don't foul.
It's a disgrace. Just a disgrace. They ought to be ashamed of themselves.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
It's the most wonderful week.
A matchup between two of the nation's best. Chris Brown and Colorado battle Anthony Davis and the Badgers. Capital One Bowl Week continues with the Alamo Bowl, presented by MasterCard. Tonight at 8 on ESPN.
Well, another member of that Pitino coaching family, not quite on the same level of intensity. Billy Donovan's Gators taking on Bethune-Cookman, the fabulous freshman. Matt Walsh, steal and one. And Walsh, one more time, violating the no-spin zone and going to the cup, and Florida on top easily, 14-6. UConn destroying Central Connecticut right now. They've doubled them up, still 11 and change to go in the game.
Now we've got a much closer one going on here as Rick Pitino's Cardinals have come back from an 11-point deficit to take a 5-point lead over Kentucky. Maybe the most interested observer in the house today, Lois Stone, Marvin's mom. Of course, Marvin playing 2.5 years in Kentucky before transferring to Louisville. UK tried to block it for a while, then they let him go. Boy, Jimmy Dykes, what's going through her mind here today?
Well, I tell you what, it's interesting when Marvin expressed interest to transfer to Louisville. Rick Pitino said, I talked to Marvin's mom. She said, my baby needs to work, and my baby needs discipline, and I'll stand behind you no matter what, coach. Rick Pitino said it was a done deal at that time. He's got mom support. He can go to work, man.
You get mom, you get the kid.
That's it.
I'll tell you one thing. She also praised Tubby Smith. Said, you know, Tubby was great for my son.
Logan's off on the three. Wildcats ice cold from outside. More pops right now to Louisville.
He had the trail and missed the trail. You got to communicate in transition. You got to talk. You got to communicate.
Marvin Stone, she said, hey, trailing.
His mom says, I love my big guy. That's my guy. You got a trailer right now, Mr. Dean. Find the trailer. But he's going to let him know. He's going to let him know he's behind him. He had a slam dunk, which would have brought the house down had he just dumped it over his shoulder. The magnificent Marvin.
Marvin Stone averaged 20 points and 12 rebounds in his first two games with Louisville against Manhattan and Furman. Today, he's now got 7 points and 5 rebounds against his old team.
Well, you know, Manhattan, he had a big game. As you look at him, can't watch the action. He had a great game against Manhattan, and Rick Pitino reminds us Bobby Gonzalez, one of the good young coaches. As you look at him, look, she's trying to peek. She wants to take a peek. He made him cheer. Come on, cheer. He made them both. Smile. Smile, Mrs. Stone. Smile.
I'll tell you one thing, he's going to be a big asset here in that Louisville uniform. And they're only going to get better and better, this young Cats team.
Daniels, look out. Stone trying to take the charge, and Kentucky turns it over out of bounds.
I said, Cats team, you think of Stone wearing a Cats over at the young car. I mean, it's tough to keep up with this soap opera. Who's wearing what uniform? Who's coaching where? You watch Petito on that sideline. It's hard to believe that a Mike Krzyzewski would ever coach at North Carolina. That's doing one of those games.
How about Kentucky? They have scored only 2 points in almost 5 minutes here in the second half. Antoine Dean had a big three in the first half. Brian Northern came off the bench and hit a couple. And a bit of a late whistle, but the call goes against Kentucky.
I'll tell you, if Kentucky's going to win this basketball game, somebody's got to introduce Marquise Estill to the team. He's only one shot he's taken thus far in this game, and he's a major factor on the inside all year for them.
Later on this afternoon, ABC makes its season debut of NCAA basketball as number 19 Kansas, led by Nick Collison and Kirk Heinrich, take it on the Cal Bears. They've lost only once, and that was an overtime loss to Georgia. It's NCAA basketball presented by UBS Payne Weber on ABC. You talked about Esco. Remember that against North Carolina, he didn't touch the ball, they didn't find him, and then in the second half, he has scored all 20 of his points, and they wound up winning by 17.
I mean, this kid can't take one shot. There is no way, with his ability on the inside, that he should be only shooting the basketball one time. He's got to get touches inside, and he's got to be active, because he creates opportunities on the perimeter once he's effective down in that three-second area.
Again, the pressure by Louisville. Hawkins back into the game now for Kentucky. Give him another ball handler. Fitch.
Short-armed it.
Yep.
Short-armed it.
Got it back. Everything being contested right now by the Cardinals, who are just a different team now than they were in the first 10 minutes of the game.
Yeah, their personality is so different. I think in the beginning they might have been a little bit intimidated. Look at him short-armed. He's not following through. Not getting that great rotation. This is a very important time, the next 4 minutes, to get to the 10-minute mark for Kentucky. Kentucky needs a spurt, and they need it badly. And they're going to have to get Estill to give them some basketball inside. Take the ball in the basket.
There it goes. Had it knocked away, and a foul is called on Louisville. For more on Kentucky, let's go to Jimmy Dykes. Jimmy?
Guys, we're talking about Marquise Estill for Kentucky. Louisville coaches told me this week really a basic thing in this game. Keep Kentucky's guards out of the paint and keep Estill out of the paint. Push him off. He's not near as effective. If you get him off the high percentage spot on the floor, Louisville's doing a very good job. Look where he's at right now with that ball.
Well, right now they've got to put Myles on him because Stone just picked up his third foul. We'll see if that changes anything.
That would attack Stone right now. Whoever he's guarding, I bring the ball inside of Marvin.
There it is. Kamara is the guy who Stone is guarding, and it's Kamara with the easy dude.
Yeah, you get the easy basket. That's where you want to bring the basketball. That's good basketball IQ.
So Marvin Stone's going to have to play through some moderate foul trouble here in the second half.
And Kentucky's going to have to lock up the three. The three is such a big part of the arsenal of Louisville. And that could stretch that lead to where it gets the danger time. They like that penetration and kick it out.
Jumper from the corner for Dean.
And there's the three. We just talked about it. He can flat out shoot the three.
Let's go back just so we get it right. I was incorrect. Stone as to it's Gaines who has his third foul for Louisville. Here goes Gaines.
They got Brown for the layup.
And Estill with great hustle on the defensive end to get a piece of the ball as he tumbles over the cheerleaders out of bounds.
That's a terrific play by Marquise.
Kamara open his second bucket.
Kamara with two quick baskets. Yep.
A very skilled player who's been in and out of the starting lineup for Kentucky over the years.
Stone only has two right now. Three.
Yeah, Stone with two. It's Gaines with three as he takes it into traffic. And Stone fouled from behind by Estill.
What intensity. I mean, I stand up for you people at home. We're sitting 5 feet away from the court. And I'm telling you, the intensity, the emotion, it is unbelievable. College basketball, it's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
Number three on Marquise Estill, Marvin Stone to the line.
Now you know why at 63 I act about 10, man. I act about 10.
And why you'll keep doing this as long as you can.
I want to do it like my heroes, guys. You think about Keith Jackson, keep going on and on with his enthusiasm. Whoa, Nelly.
Gaines comes out. Whitehead back in. Stone back to the line. You see his numbers from a year ago. Played 9 games for Kentucky before leaving the program.
Come on, come on, Mom. You're going to shoot her. Enjoy the moment. Oh, he came up empty.
You can tell from the reaction without ever having to open up her eyes.
What about a crowd noise?
Yep. Nestor again, always looking ahead. Hawkins, beautiful feet inside to Barber, and one.
Antoine Barber had a broken left hand. This is his first game he's played in quite a while, and he's going to be a valuable asset to this team. Led Wabash Valley out in Illinois to the National Junior College Championship 2 years ago. Look at him spread the court. Now look at this, good angle. That's what you want to do, go to the opposite side of the traps, and then you want somebody that can finish like Antoine Barber.
And now, Dick, that is the third foul on Marvin Stone. So Garcia, Gaines, and Stone all with 3 fouls for Louisville, and now Rick Pitino's gone deeper into the bench. Whitehead is in, Northern is in, and Dean is in, and all 3 of them were factors in the first half.
Yeah, he's not afraid to use his bench. He's always been a guy that likes to rotate people in. Nice screen.
Dean almost got up in the air, got lucky, found Whitehead. Nice backdoor pass.
Give it up.
Dean, extra pass. Stone, yes.
Nice pass in a basketball. Dean with the good look and Stone with the finish. I would try to attack Stone to get 4. He's not going to guard. No, I'd throw the ball inside.
Brown, maybe to prevent that from happening, went out and grabbed Barber on the drive.
Louisville very unselfish in their previous possession. We're going to watch the ball as it's dumped down inside. We're going to see Dean run a little backdoor cut right here. Freeze it. See right here. He draws 2 people. Now he gives it up. And there's the layup. Give it up. Mr. Stone's going to finish. That was not an easy shot. Got the power move on the inside. Going to sit with the 3 fouls. Have them ready for down the stretch.
Ellis Myles checks back into the game for Louisville. Also, Larry O'Bannon, a sophomore from right here in Louisville, gets his first action of the afternoon.
You know, Dan, 2 other players had to play against their former teams. Dan Miller had to do it for Notre Dame against Maryland, responded with 17 points and a big win where they were chanting, "Where's your ring, Danny?" down in there in Washington, D.C. Also, Todd Billett against Rutgers got 22 for Virginia going back home.
And in both cases, the new team beat the former team.
Right.
And Louisville trying to make it 3-for-3.
They're trying to go 3-for-3.
Here's Northern. 2 huge threes late in the first half.
They were big. They were monster threes.
Whitehead, who has completely remade his jump shot in the offseason, spent a lot of time with a shooting coach. Everything from footwork to hand position on the ball, and he looked pretty good right there.
Did a great job of rotating the ball. They made the extra pass. Got a turnover. Kentucky out of rhythm right now. Kentucky out of sync against the Louisville defense. Oh, this may be upset city, baby. Maybe upset city.
In 1935, Foxwood Farm started with one horse and a truck. The horse was a thoroughbred. The truck, a Chevy Suburban. Today, they have a few more horses. But there's still only one truck. Chevy Suburban. With an available 8.1-liter Vortec engine, it's capable of towing up to 6 tons, making it the best Suburban yet. Chevy Suburban, like a rock.
College basketball on ESPN. It's a primetime doubleheader to cap off a full day of rim-rocking action. First, North Carolina and their star freshman Rashad McCants take it strong to the hole against Miami. Then, 2 heavyweights trade blows as Chris Hill and Michigan State look to shut down Oklahoma's silky smooth guard Hollis Price. North Carolina, Miami, and Michigan State, Oklahoma cap a full Saturday of college hoops on ESPN and ESPN.
Bring foot over to the side, keeping the spine tall.
Orthopedically designed seats. Ergonomically designed interior. There are 75 reasons to drive a Volvo S80.
Yoga, huh?
And a great reason to do it now during the season for savings and safety. Purchase or lease a luxurious Volvo S80 before December 31st and get one of the best prices of the year. See Tapple for details.
Do you play Kentucky Cash Ball? Just match 4 numbers plus the cash ball and you can win up to $200,000. Just like Carl Joyner, Dolly Burton, Sandra Cook. And with 6 drawings a week, as you can imagine, there's always lots and lots of winners. Probably someone you know. In fact, there are over 6,000 winners a day. That's almost 40,000 winners a week. So with all these winners, you ought to be playing Kentucky Cash Ball.
Did I just see Uncle Henry?
Reese Davis with you in the studio. What a great matchup in the Nokia Sugar Bowl Classic. Mississippi State against Oklahoma. The freshman, D'Angelo Alexander, saving it to Hollis Price, but the Dogs are on top by two right now. Don't forget, coming up at the top of the hour, Bob Knight leading Texas Tech in against Minnesota. Signing some autographs for the kids. Perhaps got a bowl of soup with that hat. Looks good on him, though.
Oh, easy for you to say from the studio. A little colder up there in Minnesota than it is down in Lubbock. Hey, while we have a moment, we'd like to welcome the airmen of the 31st Red Horse Flight, red the dominant color in this building here today, who support military operations from the Leghorn Army Depot in Livorno, Italy. They're watching the game on AFN, the American Forces Network. We'd like to welcome you to Freedom Hall in Louisville, Kentucky. Dan Shulman, Dick Vitale, Jimmy Dykes with you. The Louisville Cardinals were down by as many as 11 in the first half to Kentucky. Now they're up 10 in spite of the fact, and we can't say this enough, Reese Gaines has no field goals and 2 points in the game.
That is amazing when you think of that number.
More than a 33.
I tell you, Morgan has done a great job. You know, I said upset city earlier. Obviously played here at Freedom Hall. A lot of people would say it's a pick'em game, but the bottom line is, as far as I'm concerned, Kentucky comes in as the higher-ranked team. Comes in with a program that's in gear. Louisville with Patino in his second year. To me, I'm talking me. I'm not talking about anybody else. I would classify it in my mind. I would give right now, I'd call it an upset. Yeah, and Louisville winning.
Yeah, no, I think most people would agree with you. Fitch knocks down to 3 to bring it back down to 10. Louisville, by the way, they're not ranked, as you can see, Kentucky 14. The Cardinals have not been ranked in 4 years. Myles inside, got right underneath the basket, got it back, and makes it pay off.
They are out hustling right now, Kentucky. Kentucky was out scrapping them early in the game, but this has been all Louisville, and their defense has taken away the rhythm offensively of Kentucky.
I'd love to know at what point in the first half, in what timeout, Rick Pitino said something to his team and lit a fire under them, because they looked like they were sleepwalking through the first 10 minutes of this game.
I think it was a lot of jitters, a lot of nervousness. A lot of times when you're nervous, you can't play at that high level. You look at his staff with him. He's got an outstanding young guy, Mick Cronin, who does a phenomenal job recruiting, was at Cincinnati. And their recruits, it's getting better and better. What does he do the night before the game, Mr. Pitino? He takes the half the team with him to a high school game to see Jamie Lang play here in Louisville. They got a picture in the paper with him and his, all his players watching Jamie Lang play.
There's Esther. Now a senior, and again, a good friend of Marvin Stone. Two guys who know each other extremely well, and two guys who at times seem to have the physical ability to take over a game, but Estill's had a very quiet game and not many touches at all here today.
I said, what a tough stretch for Kentucky, playing Michigan State, playing Indiana, playing North Carolina, playing Louisville. At least now they get two games coming up. They have Tennessee State and Auburn State. I mean, on the 30th and the 2nd, those are two games they should win, obviously. And you know what? They deserve a little break in that first-class competition with their schedule.
Chuck Hayes called it respect month for Kentucky here in December, feeling they're going to get a little respect by playing the tough schedule they're playing. Here's a couple great games coming up after us on ESPN today. Texas Tech is up in Minnesota immediately following our game. Keep an eye on Andre Emmett. This guy can score into bunches, and then it's Bob Knight's old team, Indiana Hoosiers, taking on Temple in the third game of the triple header. That starts at 4 Eastern. Garcia, boy, he is not shy at all. See, that's a freshman. Gaines wide open.
And Gaines finally gets the 3 to go. What a big lift that is psychologically for them. Getting their star player up to 19 a game. That's his first basket. Oh, look at Pitino doing the dance. He's like the wrist was up on the sideline. He's working that sideline. Rick Pitino. Energy, enthusiasm, excitement. He's the 3 there, man.
And you could throw in the 4, the entrepreneur.
And I'll tell you, he is an entrepreneur.
There's Myles, a great look to Gaines. Finally, his first made basket of the game.
Look at him out hustling on the inside. There's the kick out. There's Gaines with the release. He's from out of Wisconsin. Said no to the Badgers. He's trying to put that program together big time. We got a kid coming in next year, Butch. 7-footer, outstanding player. Chuck Hayes got some body. Look at this right here.
Woo. Getting to the line.
Oh, he's so physical inside. Yeah. Offensive rebounds.
You know, maybe it's the time, Dick, that we now turn the tables a little bit and talk about Kentucky and Keith Bogans. Maybe it's time for him to step up and lead his team back into the game.
Backdoor Pepe just ran a good switch right there defensively at Bogans' feet for a layup.
Whitehead's going to get called for the moving screen.
Next 4 minutes, Jimmy Dykes.
Trust me, next 4 minutes so big for Kentucky. They must go on a spurt, Jimmy Dykes, in the next 4 minutes.
Dick, I tell you what they better start doing is getting back to attacking that ball when it's above the rim. I was in the Louisville huddle the last time out. All five assistant coaches, the last words out of their mouth, keep rebounding that basketball. Kentucky better get after it.
Bogans, nice look inside.
About time. Somebody introduced him to Mark Lucesto. He's like unstoppable if he gets touches on the inside. Bring the ball inside. And it's going to clock a little bit, but you don't want to get too cautious. A lot of time on that clock.
Trying to get a couple minutes off the clock, maybe, before they bring Stone back into the game. Garcia calmly steps inside his man, misses the baseline jumper, and Hayes there to do the dirty work underneath for Kentucky.
Good positioning by Hayes.
Bogans takes the clock, keeps on going, and scores.
And that's his game. Attack the basket. He did it so well as a freshman. Little spurt. Here comes a little Kentucky spurt.
And Rick Pitino wants a timeout. Keith Bogans on two consecutive possessions playing within himself. Got things done for the Wildcats.
There he is with the great dump down inside. Experience, the more experience. And then a second time, he used his ability. Nice change of direction. Gets in a little stutter. Great move to the basket. Keith Bogans. Played with Joseph Forte together at the Matha for Morgan Wooten.
The three not falling for Bogans today, so he's going inside, and he's now got 10 points. Kentucky back within seven. Don't forget, tonight at 8 Eastern here on ESPN, Capital One Bowl Week continues. A clash between Chris Brown and number 14 Colorado and Anthony Davis and Wisconsin in the Alamo Bowl presented by MasterCard. It's a battle of running backs, both Brown and Davis averaging well over 100 yards per game. Here, Keith Bogans, back-to-back good possessions for him. But like Gaines and some of the others, his numbers below where you would expect him to be today.
Well, you know, Gaines from out of Wisconsin, I'm sure he's going to root for the Badgers.
That's right.
Gaines, but they're going to have to find a way. Mr. Alvarez to stop Chris Brown. He's one of the best running backs in the nation.
Kind of a gut check now for this young Louisville team. Stone, a senior, back into the game now for the Cardinals.
That's a walk. That's a walking violation.
Yeah, Gaines thought he got hit by Fitch.
You know, both these coaches do such a great job defensively. And one of my favorite people, C.M. Newton, was the athletic director at Kentucky who hired Tubby Smith and also hired Rick Pitino. And certainly C.M., one of the classiest guys ever to work in intercollegiate athletics, knows about winners. And he told me the moment he hired Tubby, he wasted no time. Tubby was his guy right from the opening moment that Mr. Pitino went to the Celtics.
Eskel and Stone matched up on one another.
Get it back inside to Eskel. Get it back inside.
They tried, but it was knocked away.
Lefty speed should have tucked it right inside. With three fouls, Stone would check up.
Cliff Hawkins is trying to come back into the game now for Kentucky, and Barber will come out.
You know, I mentioned when Rick Pitino went to the Celtics, I firmly believe had he stayed at Kentucky, he would have the achievements of Mike Krzyzewski at Duke and would be a Hall of Famer. I really believe that. I think that he is born to coach on a college environment and in a college landscape with his personality and his teaching ability and motivational ability.
Well, he's an integral part of the great history of Kentucky, this being the 100th year of Kentucky basketball, and 43 appearances in the NCAA tournament, more than anybody else, 13 Final Fours, including seven national championships, one of them under the guidance of Rick Pitino. And you can see what he's done all the time. He did it at BU, he did it at Providence, he did it at Kentucky, and now he's trying to bring this Louisville program all the way back to national prominence as well.
3 years in a row, Kentucky in 96, 97, and 98, won over 30 games. That's incredible.
Gaines somehow found Myles, who draws the foul. For more on Rick Pitino, let's go to Jimmy Dykes.
Hey, Dick, I want to get your opinion on this as well. I really feel like Rick Pitino is maybe one of 15 or 20 guys on the college level that truly, truly now coaches on their own terms. You know what I'm saying? In practice, if you don't perform, brother, you don't play. And he only recruits kids that have a passion for basketball. There's no sacrificing going on in Rick Pitino and his system. What do you think?
Yeah, the bottom line is at practice, you have to perform or you're not going to play. you're not going to get playing time unless you perform at practice. And now they tell me he utilizes a microphone in practice, one of the few coaches that coaches with a microphone in practice. This guy is an absolute born coach. He lives it, he eats it. It started at the five-star basketball camp years and years ago. Look at his former assistants, what they have done. I mean, it's just incredible what he has done against them. But the bottom line is, let me tell you, this guy is a flat-out winner. Russell learned a lot under Hubie Brown, who's now doing a great job with the Grizzlies.
Hey, Bill, I need to talk to you.
What is it, you and Karen break up?
No, that's not it.
Then what?
You remember how we decided that we'd have more money to buy Bud Light if we got a third roommate?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know if I can take her anymore.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down.
Charge.
Make it a Bud Light.
The new Silverado is here, now with quadrasteer four-wheel steering. It's the most maneuverable full-size pickup you can get. Silverado, the truck from Chevy.
That won't fill you up and never let you down. Make it a Bud Light.
Well, the guys in the red are beating the guys in the blue right now by eight, but there's plenty of time remaining. One guy who knows about both programs, Rick Pitino, talks about the difference between Louisville fans and Kentucky fans.
They love going to the game. They want to beat Kentucky in the worst way, but it's not life and death. This is a social event. They love the game. They want to win badly, but that's the end of it. In Kentucky, it's literally, it's, people will go out and leave themselves in the snow for hours after the game and punish themselves. It's life and death at Kentucky, where it's not at Louisville.
Well, there's a guy who knows a lot about Kentucky basketball. Jimmy, who's this?
Well, Bill Kightley. He's been the equipment manager on that UK bench for 42 years. This is his 1,273rd game today. I can tell you this. There's no way this is just another game to Bill Kightley. He doesn't celebrate Christmas, guys, until after the Louisville game every year, and then only if they win.
Wow.
He may not be opening packages right now, huh?
I'll tell you what, he bleeds Kentucky blue. He really does. Bill Kightley, special guy.
Dean from Garcia. A couple of freshmen making it happen there.
They are really playing with a special bounce now. They're attacking. They're anticipating well.
Hawkins, look at the hands swiping at the ball constantly on the Louisville end, and they get a tie up here. The arrow, though, will keep it with the Wildcats.
This is the kind of game, if you win, if you're Louisville, that you build on. That you build on a game like this. That's Fitch trying to attack the basket. There's the check, block shot, excellent job defensively. I tell you, you can build on a game like this, and Rick Pitino's a master of doing that as well.
Bogan from Hawkins, left it short, rebound Stone.
I thought he got fouled.
By Hawkins at the other end to get back on D.
Officials have done an excellent job in this game, and I thought they missed one there. Tony Green, Thibodeau, and certainly Kerry Sitton have done an outstanding job. We haven't talked about the officials at all, so you know they're doing a good job.
Right now, Marvin Stone, by the way, 11 points and 6 rebounds, the exact numbers he had for Kentucky against Louisville 2 years ago.
That's amazing how big he was in that game with such a spark. And he's a spark here by just his presence alone. Not only the 11 points, his presence creates opportunities on the perimeter.
Yeah, well, and keep in mind, too, Marquise Estill is right now on the bench with 4 fouls, and Estill's had only 2 field goal attempts the entire game. Stone's got to get some of that credit.
No question about it. Didn't get any touches on the inside. They've done a good job of keeping the ball away from him.
You got to make some threes here. Somebody's going to have to step up and make some threes for Kentucky.
Pitch into Kamara.
Defense making it work for a good shot.
Trying to back down Stone. Can't do it. Over the top. No. Rebound Louisville.
What a great job rebounding from the 5 minute mark of the second half to now. First half, they were so dominated by Kentucky. 15-1, if you want to believe it, on the glass. 15-1 in the first 15 minutes. That's a little turnaround jump shot by Kamara. They have a good outside rebounding position. They want some contact here.
Myles with his 12th rebound of the game. Got a swipe in the face, fell out of bounds, and Kentucky gets the ball back.
You know, Myles, an outstanding rebounder. He's a good position rebounder, especially on the offensive boards. They're really celebrating a lot of these fans, man. They're watching that clock. They're saying, wow, this could be a happy, joyous time in Louisville.
Kentucky's won three in a row in this series, and they lead the series overall 23-10.
Nick Pitino was 6-2 in the 8 years that he was at Kentucky against Louisville.
Fish somehow found Kamara.
Got to shoot the ball, man. Shoot the three.
Hayes inside. No.
I mean, they come up with a drive like that and pass up good opportunities on the perimeter. It looked early in this game that we were possibly going to have a blowout.
Yep.
The way Kentucky had, they made threes, the way they were rebounded, but they weren't shooting well from the three. And then all of a sudden, Morgan's two threes and Dean's three at the half. Those three threes changed the complexion of this game.
Rebounding, a huge story as well, the first 10 minutes. And then since, and Tubby Smith has decided he can wait no longer. He's putting Estill back into the game with four fouls.
Can't wait, Dan. Can't wait.
Yep.
Got to play him now.
Shot clock at 10 as the Wildcats inbound for the baseline.
Louisville really attacks on the perimeter. Doesn't give you good looks.
Hands in. Francisco Garcia, who's had a terrific game.
You know, Dean and Garcia didn't get the kind of notoriety and publicity a lot of these impact type of dandies have received, but they are solid contributors in this rotation.
Garcia out of the Bronx, Dean out of New Jersey.
Nice
inside, Stone, and Kamara is called for the foul.
Nice two-man game. Garcia with the great size, looks right over the top of the defense. I tell you, what an excellent pass inside. Great job, Garcia. Look at the screen release. Freeze that baby. Look at him. Now they're going to attack him. He's going to take that ball up quick to the basket. Quick to the basket. He gets the contact. You think he's a little excited right now looking at the scoreboard, Mr. Stone? You think he's a little excited? He's trying to make it 3-for-3 like Dan Millett did with Maryland. And Todd Millett did with Virginia against Rutgers. And Millett with Notre Dame against Maryland. And now Mr. Stone. Try to beat his former school.
Again, 11-6 right now, pending the outcome of the second free throw, the exact numbers he put up for Kentucky against Louisville 2 years ago.
You know, he's matured a lot because he has to take a lot of the blame for his play down in Kentucky. He really didn't have the kind of effort and energy, didn't do the job like he was supposed to, have some little academic problems as well, had a few things off the court. But the bottom line is, he's matured. And you salute anybody that makes that change in their life, gets going in a positive way.
But he knew he had one last shot if he wanted a chance to play professional basketball. He's got dreams, obviously, of playing in the NBA, so he wanted a change of scenery. And Rick Pitino said, you got to work, but I'll come take you. And Louisville was thin inside. It's been a great marriage between the two parties.
Now she's getting a little bit more solid if they get a W here.
Yeah, that's right. By far the toughest game so far for Louisville, their first ranked opponent of the season. Their only loss came against Purdue. Is that Estill out on the perimeter?
That's five.
If it is, he's done.
That's Mark Bruce Estill out on the perimeter. You got to know better than that. You know you're valuable to your team. 5 minutes on the clock. You're 25 feet away from the basket. Not a good play right there by Mark Weiss. 6 points, six rebounds. They did a great job negating him on the interior. Look at this here. Going to foul out here. Now you got four fouls. Yeah, why would you make that? That's not a heady play. That's not a smart play right there. Not a smart play.
A huge loss inside for Kentucky. Hayes comes back in. Kalena Azubuki, a freshman from Tulsa, is in the game now for Kentucky as well. But this is a very, very small lineup.
They go smaller. You can see the way he's just pumping a little handshake there, Mr. Stone, how excited he is. Azubuki is a scorer. He can score a lot of points quickly.
And they're going to need somebody to do that in a hurry. Let's go to Jimmy Dykes for more, Jimmy.
You know that Stone and Estill, you know Stone and Estill know each other well from practice against one another. And I think they did an outstanding job of keeping Estill pushed off the block offensively in this ballgame and never allowed him, Dick, to get in a rhythm and get in a comfortable flow.
And they also did a great job taking away the offensive efficiency of Kentucky with their little trap. They may not be forcing steals and turnovers, but they're disruptive. And being disruptive has taken Kentucky out of any rhythm. And they are absolutely jubilant here over at Freedom Hall.
More great basketball coming up right behind us. Bob and I in Texas Tech heading up north back into the Big Ten as they take on Minnesota. That's the game immediately following the end of our game and then the third game of the triple header. Coach Knight's old team, the Indiana Hoosiers, against Temple. Jock Chaney back on the sideline. Feeling better, as Dick mentioned earlier today. What a great afternoon of college basketball here on the ESPN.
Okay, he's got a nice stroke for a big guy. You know, in the 1980s, you can say that Louisville was probably one of the teams you'd have to rate as a team of the 80s. In 80 and 86, yep. Winning the national title under Denny Crum. And then in the 90s, you make a case for Duke and Kentucky as a team of the 90s. But I know what there in the 2000s. Let me tell you, man, Mr. Pacino, give him two more years, and I'm telling you, he'll be top five in America every year. Two more years, at least top ten.
That's a good game inside. No, Kamara couldn't get the rebound. Myles has yet another rebound. His 13th of the afternoon.
Did they change their rebounding ability here after the first 15 minutes? Got more aggressive, blocked out, really went after the basketball.
Games.
And the maestro man today is Mr. Pacino. He's wheeling all kinds of music, conducting an unbelievable song, swishing the net. He's dancing with joy. He's got that great look, he said to us today. He said, you know what? Last year I was in a daze, man. And you can understand why. He lost his best friend, Billy Minardi, his brother-in-law, his wife Joanne's brother, 9/11 in the World Trade Center. And he said it was absolutely a nightmarish year. Also lost another brother-in-law who got hit by a taxi in New York City, as you see games. He said, but this year, we're starting to get back into the flow again, and I'm back coaching, and I'm back enjoying coaching. He says, last year, I was in a daze.
And look at the atmosphere that he has brought to Louisville here. And Denny Crum had a phenomenal 30-year run. I mean, let's not lose sight of what
he's a Hall of Famer.
That's right.
He's a Hall of Famer. Louisville's always been good basketball-wise.
But at the end of Crum's reign, 30 years, Louisville had slipped the last couple of years. And as soon as Pacino came back in, everybody went, oh, things are going to change.
Oh, you knew it.
Pretty quickly.
You knew it. The guy's got unbelievable work ethic. He's got unbelievable, you know, reputation. Kids love it. You mentioned earlier, Dan, so well. You said how Dean and Garcia wanted to come here as soon as he got the job. They wanted to play for him.
And how can you be in this atmosphere or be a hotshot kid sitting at home watching this game and not want to be a part of this kind of basketball?
This guy looks so young. He's going, he knows in his mind this game is far from over right now. It's far from over in his mind. Oh, a little bump right there.
A little acting by Hawkins.
Yeah, he pulled a little one. Jack Nicholson.
Yeah. But let's go back about an hour when it was 15-1 rebounds for Kentucky. Reese Gaines was a non-factor. Three Cardinals had two fouls midway through the first half. They were lucky to be down six and then five and then three. Now they're up by 16.
I'll tell you, the three threes that changed the whole complexion of the game were the two by Northern and the one by D. And they love it here at Freedom Hall. It is all Louisville.
Sorry about the dust.
Come on, guys, let's go.
The powerful new Chevy Trailblazer EXT. Room for seven. Room for everything.
I left the bagels in the jet.
Chevy Trailblazer, like a rock.
Is it 5/16 or 9/32? Does it take a standard socket or metric? What you need is the original Gator Grip, the amazing socket that works on over 1,000 nuts, bolts, and fasteners. Now hang a plant, work under the hood, or set up a Christmas tree stand quickly and easily. The secret are these unbreakable alloy steel rods that form to fit most any size or shape. Even damaged and stripped bolts are no problem. You get the Gator Grip with the heavy-duty ratcheting handle, plus the adapter for power drills and drivers, all for only $19.95. Order now.
These people are making a New Year's resolution to enjoy life. They all called Hair Club.
If you feel good about yourself, you'll be able to accomplish anything you want.
It was the best phone call I ever made.
The me that you see right now is the me that I want you to see. It's the best me. That's what Hair Club is.
Make your resolution. Call 1-800-HAIR-CLUB today.
Rich.
Vishmufu Ion Pulsiger Divimert.
Thanks, Tony.
Next. Ms. Verdunos.
It's going to be a wild finish on Sunday NFL Countdown.
All that wacky AFC.
We'll preview all the playoff possibilities and zoom in on the Dolphins and the Patriots. Fasten your seatbelts. 11 a.m. Sunday on ESPN.
More from another heavyweight battle down in New Orleans, the Nokia Sugar Bowl Classic. Oklahoma and Mississippi State waning kicks. Hollis Price almost loses his balance and hits the jumper late. OU and the Dogs tied at 23 at the half. And don't forget, coming up as soon as we're done, Rick Rickard leading Minnesota against the Generals Red Raiders. Texas Tech and Minnesota coming up in a matter of moments.
And back here, a 17-point lead, Reese, for Louisville over Kentucky after trailing by as many as 11 in the first half. They love Rick Pitino here in Louisville, and they know their basketball. They know that Bob Knight is coming up next on ESPN as Texas Tech takes on Minnesota. Don't forget, we mentioned this in the first half. Each of the last 8 years, whichever one of these schools has won the annual football game between the two of them has lost the basketball game, and that trend is 3 minutes and 42 seconds away from continuing. Norvin, he's got Ellis Myles. It's Dunk City. It's Dunk City. The Bill is rocking. Mr. Pitino has brought back the enthusiasm, the spirit of once proud program really slipped a little bit. And now it is getting back. It is climbing step by step. And this is a big step in a positive way. Oh, what a play by Eric Brown after he tried for a steal. Got caught up in midcourt and he hustled back down to the baseline to steal. You know, at the end of the game, it's going to be all about Pitino and Stone, but two guys shouldn't be forgotten. Ellis Myles and the blue-collar work he's done today, and the guy with the ball right now, Bryant Northern, huge off the bench for the Cardinals.
And what about Garcia? Yeah. What about the defensive effort? And then two big threes by Gabe. But you're right, the story will be Pitino, will be Stone. But the bottom line, it was a great team effort defensively that put him into this incredible lead here.
Northern with the shot clock running down, and this is everything. Stone, by the way, with 16 points and 7 rebounds. If this continues and Louisville's going to win fairly easily, he's going to get one of those moments that everybody dreams of where he comes off all by himself for a substitution near the end of the game and the place goes nuts.
Well, you got to feel good for the kid. He's had a lot of negatives, a lot of down things that have happened. We talked about lost his dad, lost his sister, transferred, didn't live up to the billing coming out of Alabama. Was the subject of a chapter in a book, Soul Influence, by Dan Wetzel and by Don Yeager. The bottom line is, this is a moment a kid dreams of, just like a Dan Miller going back against Maryland and a Todd Billett against Rutgers.
And a moment mom dreams of, too.
Yes, sir. Mom's got to feel good because anytime the son does well, moms always feel good.
Bogans at the line. Garcia just committed his fourth foul. Estill has fouled out. Four Kentucky.
You know, in 1980, Louisville had the Doctors of Love and won the national title. That was the year they lost to Iona. Iona's only beat two national teams in 23 years. Yesterday, North Carolina, and here. And I got a letter from Mike LaPree from the SID. He sends me a letter. I opened it yesterday, and he says, Dick, we are going to surprise everyone. You watch what we do to Carolina. And they beat Carolina, Mike LaPree, Iona.
And the bad news,
Jeff
if you
Rulon.
Missed it for Carolina, Sean May broke his score.
Yeah,
he's
tough
out
loss.
8 to 10 weeks.
Tough loss. We wish him the best. He's such a valuable part of that team. And that's the one player in North Carolina couldn't afford to miss, the inside presence of May.
Garcia. Garcia, baseline, hangs it in. What a player.
He's a big-time player. He's got that what we talked about at the five, the athletic talent, the agility. He's smiling. Who'd have ever dreamt when they went down 11 that they would be up 20 on Kentucky?
Rebound, Myles is 14th. Garcia, the freshman, by the way, with a dozen points.
Oh, wow. Last year was a 20-point blowout. They were all over Mr. Patino. They called him the traitor. They had a sign about his wife. Joanne, we don't like you either, because they thought she didn't like it at Lexington. Well, let me tell you, a year later, look what has happened here in Louisville. It's a beating. They're giving him a beating. It's a spanking. It's a whipping.
And like so many of the other leagues in the country, Conference USA, especially on Louisville's side, looks wide open between Louisville, Marquette, Cincinnati. There's going to be some great basketball in Conference USA this year.
Yeah, and also in the SEC. Alabama, Georgia, Florida, Mississippi State, LSU, we saw the other day, looked outstanding in that win over Arizona. I mean, they could get seven teams out of that conference in the NCAA this year, possibly. Oh, they got to be happy with this performance. Certainly a down moment right now and a long ride on that bus. Jimmy Dykes, let me ask Jimmy Dykes. He was a member of the coaching staff at Kentucky, and he knows what that ride is like. What is that ride like going from Louisville back to Lexington, especially with a loss? What is that feeling like?
Dick, all losses hurt. But when you're involved in a state championship game like you're involved in today, this one hurts for a long time. You can't get it back for another 364 days. I don't know for sure if everyone understands how important this game is to the Kentucky fans. It's big for Louisville. It is huge, life or death for Kentucky fans.
And Louisville's about to snap a three-game losing streak to Kentucky. Marvin Stone won a couple of those games for Kentucky. Now he's on the winning end for Louisville, and he's had a good day. 16.7 rebounds, and that smile says it all, doesn't it?
Oh, that smile. What a difference a year makes. Look at him feeling content, joyous.
Hey, Whitehead's coming in. Could be for Stone.
Pagino told me that he's the best big man he has coached on a college level.
Wow.
In terms of skills and talent. He flat out told me to listen to the crowd.
Soaking it up, along with better than 20,000 people here inside Freedom Hall. Let's see if this is Stone coming out. Sure is.
This is it. Here it is. Standing ovation for Mr. Marvin Stone. He knows how to play the moment. With Pagino, knows how to play the moment. Do you think Mr. Pagino got his Christmas present from all those practice sessions? Double sessions? Unbelievable tenacity. Practice every day. Don't tell me this is just another game. I told him today in the locker room. I said, my buddy Tom Niederfuhr, he's the pitcher for the Dodgers.
Yeah.
We're in the locker room. And I said, come on, Rick. I don't want to hear about another game, man. This is not another game. He goes, you're right.
Yeah, he'll admit it after the game.
Yeah.
You know Marvin Stone's mom's going to have a few pages to add to the scrapbook tomorrow.
Well, at least there'll be positive pages. This guy gets the other look in.
Ellis Myles coming out. 11 points and 14 big rebounds.
And they needed those boards. They went down 15-1, people, on the glass. They were being dominated by Kentucky early in this game. Who would have ever thought they were up to it? I am stunned, shocked, and I am absolutely in disbelief. I cannot believe it. That's college hoops for you. You can't figure it out.
Kentucky will fall to 6-3. Louisville will beat its first ranked team of the season, go to 7-1, and perhaps move into the rankings
for the first time
in the last 4 years.
No, perhaps. I mean, that's going to be automatic, Louisville in there. Got the Papa John's sign behind him. John Schnatter, a big fan here, the head of Papa John's, and they actually sponsored the new stadium in football. The football stadium has beautiful chair backs. Tom George, the athletic director, just hired Bob Petrino as football coach. They're looking for one down in Kentucky. We recommend Doug Williams, man. We met him last week with Dale Brown, and what a great guy. And I think he'd be a great hire for Kentucky.
Look at those long faces on the Kentucky bench. The Louisville Cardinals have turned this game around. A 29-point turnaround from when they trailed by 11 midway through the first half. And they have beaten their arch rivals from Lexington in convincing fashion here today.
What a performance. An A-plus performance by Rick Pitino and Louisville.
Final score, Louisville 81, Kentucky 63. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. We're going to send you to more hoop action, Texas Tech and Minnesota. Here are Sean McDonough and Bill Raftery.